Welcome to this module on the local self-government setup of federalism. First, let us learn about the Panchayati Raj system. The rural self-government is popularly known as the Panchayati Raj system. It is in the rural areas. That's why it is known as rural local self-government. It is also known as Panchayati Raj system. Each village or a group of villages in some states have Gram Panchayat. So what is Gram Panchayat? It is a combination of a group of villages or a village according to the state's administration. In some states, we have at village level Gram Panchayat. In some, we have a group of villages coming together and forming a Gram Panchayat. This council consists of several ward members. So, the entire area of the villages is divided into different wards while the election process is happening, and these wards will have each one representative known as ward members, often called as panch. The ward members are known as panch. So, they also have a president for each village known as the president or sarpanch. Each village is divided into wards. Each ward will have a ward member, and among themselves they elect a president, and he is also called as sarpanch. These people are directly elected by the adult population, that is above 18 years of age, who are living in the village or in that particular ward. As I told you, each village is divided into number of wards. So each ward will have elections, and the adult population living in that particular ward will choose their own ward member. He is called as panch. And each Gram Panchayat is a decision-making body of the entire village. It is the decision-making body for the entire village. Once the Gram Panchayat meets, it calls all the members of the village. You can see here in the screen, all the members of the village come, sit, and then discuss about the issue. So the Panchayat works under the supervision of the Gram Sabha. So what is Gram Sabha? Sabha means gathering. All the voters or all the adult population living in the village are the members of the Gram Sabha. So it has to meet at least twice, or if possible thrice in a year, to approve the annual budget of the Gram Panchayat. And then they also review the performance of the Gram Panchayat. So who does all these works? The Gram Sabha. All the members of the village who are 18 years and above have the right to vote are the members of the Gram Sabha. They meet at least twice, if possible thrice in a year, to approve the annual budget of the Gram Panchayat. Now they also review the work and the performance of Gram Panchayat during these meetings when they meet to approve the annual budget of the Gram Panchayat. So the Gram Panchayat is the local unit or a single unit for a village or a group of villages where they have ward members called as panch. They have a president known as president or sarpanch. All the adult population of the village vote for these leaders, and then they choose them. The entire village will be a part of Grama Sabha, which supervises the work of Gram Panchayat and also approves the annual budget of Gram Panchayat. This is the Panchayati Raj setup at the village level. Now moving on, the Gram Panchayat are grouped and they are formed as Panchayat Samiti or the block level, which is also known as the Mandal level. So you can see the second level in this picture in the pyramid, that is the block level, Mandal level or Panchayat Samiti, which is nothing but a group of villages and Gram Panchayats known as Panchayat Samiti. Now the members of the Panchayat Samiti are the representatives of the Panchayat members who are elected in that area. So the members of the Panchayati Samiti are elected by Panchayat members in the area. Who are these Panchayat members? All the Panchayat members who are living in that particular mandal will be the members of Panchayat. All the Panchayat Samitis or mandals in the village constitute to form a Jilla Parishad, that is at the district level. Now here at the district level, when it comes to the district level, it will have the members of Lok Sabha, the members of the State Assembly MLAs, the district and some other officials at the district level will also be the members of the Zilla Parishad, the district level committee. So we have seen the Gram Panchayat, the Panchayat Samiti, which is a group of villages and group of Gram Panchayats, where the local Panchayat Samiti members will be electing them. And then the members of Panchayat Samiti of all the people, means different Panchayats together in the district, comes under the Zilla Parishad or the district level administration. Group of villages form Panchayat Samiti. Group of Panchayatis which are there within the district are known as Jilla Parishad. At the district level, you will also have the members of Lok Sabha, members of the State Assembly and other officials as a part of district level bodies. Now you may get a doubt, why do we need the members of Lok Sabha, the members of State Assembly to be the part of the Jilla Parishad or the district level of administration? Here they are ex officio members. They don't contest in any elections here. They will be as a part of the members. Whenever there are any district level meetings happening, they will be as a representatives of the state and the central level. So any issue which needs to be taken to the notice of the state government or the union government will be sent through these members. So these members will raise the issue to the next level, that is to the state level as well as to the district level, so that the issues get sorted very soon and quicker. That's why this setup has been made, so that we will also have connect between the parliament, state assemblies and also the local bodies. All the three tiers will be working together. Now let us learn about the urban local self-government, that is municipalities or municipal corporations. As I told you, the Gram Panchayats are for the rural areas. Similarly, we have municipalities for the urban areas. The big cities constituted into municipal corporations. Both municipalities and municipal corporations are controlled by elected bodies consisting of representatives who are elected by the members of that particular municipality or municipal corporation. So they have regular elections. Similarly, how the Gram Panchayat is divided, in the same way the municipals, the cities are divided into municipalities or municipal corporations. Again, they are further divided into wards, and each ward will have a corporator and they will also have a municipal chairperson in municipalities, or they will have a mayor in the municipal corporations. So municipal chairperson will be the political head of municipality. It's like towns, whereas in municipal corporations we will have a mayor who will be the political head in the cities. This new system of local government is the largest experiment in the democratic setup, which is conducted anywhere in the world. As we know, there are 684 districts in India, and it also consists nearly more than 6 lakh villages. So it is, that's why referred as the largest experiment in democracy. Constitutional status for the local government was helped in order to deepen the democratic setup in India, that is our country. Because these people are made part of the decision making process, it has helped them to understand the democratic setup. Why is it important to participate in the decision making process? It has also increased the women representation and the voice in our democracy by reserving 33% of seats in the local bodies. So in this module we learn the features of Panchayat Raj and municipal corporations as well as municipalities. That's how the local government setup is made and followed in our country. The local self-government system is considered as the largest experiment in democracy because it consists of more than 6 lakh villages, 684 districts, and it also gave a clear understanding of the constitutional setup in the rural areas as well as in the towns and cities. It has also increased the women's representation and gave strength to their voice in the setup. So these are the key features of federalism in India. That's all we have in this course. Thank you very much.